Hey, what's up? And in this video, we're going to talk about the Binance coin. It's been a long time I haven't covered any news on Binance coin, and there is a lot to cover. So let's look at the price. Binance is at a 0.92% price increase in the last 24 hours. Market cap, $68 billion, no major change. Trading volume was down 15.62% or 62% at $2.1 billion. 7-day price chart, it had some lower lows, but then they crossed the resistance level of $392, and from then the price hasn't dropped to $392 for a majority of the time, as there was a minor drop right here. So they had this lower high, lower low, another lower high, another lower low, and finally this impulse price action, followed by a quick pullback. And overall, the price is above the support level of $392, and the resistance, the new resistance level, is at $437. So yes, these were the basic stats on BNB. Let's look at what is happening with BNB. The lowdown on the drama-ridden crypto exchange. Now, Bloomberg reported in March that the firm was under investigation by the US Commodity Futures Trading Commission, with the regulatory seeking to determine whether cryptocurrency derivatives were bought and sold by US citizens on Binance platform. This was followed by another report in the May that the US Justice Department and IRS were also investigating the group. And at the same time, German watchdog BaFin issued a warning to the exchange for offering securities tracking digital tokens without publishing an investor prospectus. A lot of things have been going on with BNB or Binance, and they are being accused of doing some shady things. They were also banned by London or the UK cards payment system. So July Barclays suspended UK card payments to Binance, citing the FCA warning to customers. August saw the news that London's High Court ordered the exchange to identify hackers and freeze their accounts after AI company Fetch.ai pledged 2.6 million of its assets were stolen. So a lot of has been going on with Binance, you can read it, and that's why there are these major price fluctuations. Now, just a minute, there we go. So as you guys can see right here, Binance ordered by London High Court to track the hackers behind the 2.6 million crypto heist. Just occurred 4 days ago, but the Binance was ordered by London High Court to track the hackers behind the 2.6 million crypto heist, Reuters reported. The case puts the spotlight on the British court system's capability to track cyber criminals. It is also one of the first public ones involving Binance, the largest global crypto exchange. So these are the main points of the article. Also, Binance discontinues South Korean won trading pairs payment options. So the crypto exchange will discontinue Korean language support and remove won trading pairs. The exchange announced Friday changes to its product offerings in South Korea, including the discontinuation of the P2P merchant applications and Korean language support. Won trading pairs will be removed at 11 a.m. UTC today, with user advice to complete all trades and remove related advertisements by 10 a.m. Binance also said it intends to proactively comply with local regulations, part of its recent attempt to take the initiative in its regulatory positioning, as CEO Changpeng Zhao has indicated. Now, South Korea is not among the long list of countries whose financial watchdogs have issued warnings or notices that Binance is not permitted to be operating in its jurisdiction, though the regulatory landscape there is far from certain. The country's financial intelligence unit last month told foreign crypto exchanges they have until 24 September to register in line with the new anti-money laundering laws or face block access and possible criminal inquiries. And that's because of the lot of crypto scams going on, and the governments will have to take some action. Binance announced in December 2020 the closure of its South Korean affiliate due to low usage and volume. And okay, so let's look at this. Binance US appoints interim leadership after CEO's abrupt exit. So Binance US, the American division of the world's largest crypto exchange, has given a long-standing employee the top job after the former CEO's abrupt exit due to some accusations and other reasons. Earlier this month, Brian Brooks resigned from his role as CEO after 3.5 months. In the tweet, Brooks, who was formerly the chief legal officer for Coinbase, put the decision down to differences over strategic direction and wished his colleagues much success. Binance US has now appointed Joshua Srouch, the company's CFO since January 2020, to the role of interim CEO. Before working at the crypto exchange, Srouch was the CFO of Firestone, a management consultancy offering financial and strategic expertise to business. So this was one other major news. Also, Triple Leverage to launch Binance Smart Chain powered token. So this week marks further adoption with the blockchain sector as the well-known business travel agency Triple Leverage announced plans to launch a blockchain ecosystem. The network combines an advanced token, deflationary protocols, referral discounts, and more to provide business with new savings and return on investment opportunities. Here's what you need to know about Trip Leverage's blockchain expansion. Here's a long list of all the features of the Trip Leverage. Lastly, what does the future hold for the Binance coin? It's one of the most valuable cryptocurrencies in the world. The asset has come a long way from its early days, offering incredible value to investors despite only being available across a handful of exchanges. But after suffering a significant price hit following May's downturn, BNB appears to be making a comeback as a large crypto asset. It's one of the primary instigators of this comeback and has been rewarded handsomely as well. But investors still aren't convinced. Below, we'll look whether BNB really has the potential to move forward or is still in the doldrums. As the background technical fundamental outlook, we'll read all this right here. In some countries like UK, BNB is facing a hard time because of the accusations it's facing. And so that there are these major lower highs or higher lows and lower lows in the price of BNB. So we'll see what future holds for BNB. But as of now, I think the comeback was really, really aggressive because if you guys can see right here, after hitting $391, they were back at $411. That's quite a major pullback, I would say. No, sorry, quite a major impulsive action. But after that, it was followed by a sudden pullback down to 393 levels. So there are these major price fluctuations, but also because it's one of the major cryptocurrencies, it is bound to happen because it's the crypto market. You never know what will happen. So overall, this was all for today's video on Binance coin. If you guys like this video, if you guys like to get updates like these, make sure to give this video a like, comment down below your thoughts on the Binance coin, and also make sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel, press the bell icon next to it so you'll get notified every single day I upload videos like this. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day ahead.